My name is Stephanie Gutnick, and I run marketing and business development for BROADSIGN. BROADSIGN is a digital signage software and solutions company. We power over 260 networks across the globe in locations such as airports, some of the most prestigious in the world, to transit systems, shopping malls, point of care, waiting rooms, and even gas stations. And today we're here to discuss programmatic. So programmatic, I'd like to start just by discussing the P word in general, the term programmatic. And I remember a couple years ago when it first started to surface in our industry, people were very reluctant to even discuss the topic. We'd be at conferences and everybody just associated programmatic with what happened in digital, where it was introduced and CPMs started to fall. And fast forward to where we are now, discussions and workshops such as the one that we're having today have resulted in the industry and all players involved really understanding that we need to be programmatic equipped in order to attract some of the revenue that's being spent in other media. But we are still a little bit, we're searching for the meaning of programmatic. It still remains understood because what's happened is many flavors, as we like to call it in the BROADSIGN office, have developed. And this can range from automating the proposal generation and buying process to exposing the inventory of media publishers in our space to agencies for them to buy, to connecting directly with a DSP, a demand-side platform, to connecting with an SSP, a supply-side platform, such as BROADSIGN, and then having the inventory being optimized. So what that means is that eventually, we are going to settle on the specific terms for each workflow and then be able to discuss them in more detail and expedite how we go about putting them into place. And actually, a couple years back, I was at AdTech San Francisco attending a programmatic digital workshop, and they were saying that very soon the term programmatic would be a thing. And we would no longer even hear the word being discussed because it would just be put in place. I do believe that the same thing is going to happen in the digital out-of-home environment. Programmatic will take on the form of various workflows, but there are some challenges that need to be met before then. Namely standards, which is what BROADSIGN will be discussing today on a panel with one of our customers, actually, PrimeSite. And the thing about standards is that it's not the sexiest of topics to discuss. In fact, it will be the least sexy that we're discussing today. And as a result, people kind of put it aside and focus on the really exciting parts of what programmatic has to offer, which is information, targeting. And we have to go back and make sure that the basics are in place so we don't get too fragmented. And I'll illustrate that with an example. I was at a IAB Do task force meeting in New York last week. We were discussing many different topics, one of them being programmatic. And a lady, Maureen McClowski from Kinetic, stood up and kind of said that she would be remiss if she didn't address the elephant in the room, which is the fact that Kinetic deals with over 100 vendors each year when they're making media buys in the Do space. And that is fragmented enough. And then adding on all of these different features that differentiate each vendor is very exciting for each vendor in itself when it comes to having a competitive advantage, but it makes it even more difficult for buyers to facilitate a large-scale, sophisticated buy for their advertisers. And that's the whole promise of Do. So we're kind of doing ourselves a disservice by not making sure that we have standards implemented before we get on to the fun stuff. Now, I personally would be remiss to not take the moment to mention that BROADSIGN itself is a standard in that we power over 100,000 displays worldwide. And so if you look at the lowest common denominator of these media owners that buyers are doing their campaigns across, it will ultimately be the CMS. Our platform has a variety of different features that they can take advantage of, and that is why we work very actively with associations like the IAB and the DPAA on these programmatic task forces to make sure that all players involved, because it can't just be the vendors, it has to be the media owners, the agencies, and the companies building the pipes, taking into account what the standards will be. And this was actually reiterated yesterday when Sarah Speak from Clear Channel at the Daily Do Media Summit said, advertisers don't care who owns what screen. They just care about the location of the screen and the audience that it's reaching. So when we work together to build these standards, we'll make it very easy and attractive for advertisers to look at the digital out-of-home space and see it as a means of intuitively executing large-scale campaigns that are done programmatically in a targeted way. And one thing that I have to kind of smile about when I discuss this is that, in general, to BROADSIGN, programmatic really means two things. Let's ignore the term for a second. It's really the combination of automation and information. And when we look at automation, in 2004, when BROADSIGN brought our platform to the market, our software CMS is a content management system, we differentiated ourselves because all of the other vendors, and it remains very much this way to this day, had a playlist approach to content management. Kind of like on your iPod where you manage your songs, it was done in Excel. And Excel is manual, of course, which means that it is time consuming and prone to errors. And so what happens in the operations departments of companies running on these playlist-based systems is that if an advertiser comes to them and says, you know what, I want to change the price on this ad, and I want you to do it on these screens for these times of day in these locations, and oh, by the way, there are different languages, that means that if you're running a playlist-based system, your operations team is not going to be going home before happy hour on Friday because they're going to be stuck in the office taking care of that. BROADSIGN came to the market with a different approach, saying, okay, we have a piece of content, and we're going to do this in a rules-based way. So the piece of content gets uploaded into the system, rules are attached, and then the player is smart enough to figure out where and when it should be played back. And now this means that our player has the ability to make last-minute decisions based on local information. It's automated, and isn't that what programmatic is all about? So we've had a programmatic offering, I guess, since 2004. And when it comes to the whole direct buying aspect, as well as the real-time bidding, the RTB, for the past couple of years, we've also been working with our customers to execute what we're talking about today, programmatic buying, by integrating with various platforms that run on browser-type technologies that already have standards that are overseen by the IAB, such as RTB or Open RTB and VAST, which stands for Video Ad Serving Template. And it's not perfect. Once again, digital out of home is its own beast, and we have very unique characteristics that we need to keep in mind when looking at building out these programmatic pipes. One of them being the fact that we don't have cookies in digital out of home. So we're going to have to use multi-layering to manage the information that's being used. However, it's a start. People are becoming acquainted with programmatic, and we're learning about what works and what doesn't. So we're very excited to be working on our own means of helping our customers and the agencies that they work with develop and improve their programmatic methods. And we're also very excited to work with the other platforms in our space that are working on bringing DO into a grander scale of media. And what that means ultimately is that we're going to be competing directly with digital, directly with programmatic TV, and we'll be widening our space in a way that we've never done before, because in the past, we've always worried about the cannibalization of static out of home when improving and growing digital. And now we have the opportunity to actually, you know, expand our horizons. And I think it's very exciting, and today looking very much forward to participating and discussing the very unsexy topic of standards